Hi, I'm Caleb with DIY Bonsai. Today I want to just do a quick video on some hardwood cuttings for my Trident maple. I've got one growing over the field, needed to do some trimming today, and I'm going to just stick all of these bits and pieces into the ground, see how they grow. The bucket in front of me here has paver sand. It's got holes in the bottom of this bucket, so it's leaking like a sieve right now at the bottom. We'll see how that turns out. I've got perlite in these three buckets over here. They're rather deep. I found that it helps to have a good amount of depth when we're doing hardwood cuttings. And I've got this long piece here that just jammed in there. It's got the apical meristem still on top of it. So as much as possible, I'm trying to leave the apex on all of the branches, at least the ones that are super easy for that. The thicker ones, it just may not be possible. I've got some examples of this last year where I didn't use the apical meristem and they worked out fine. So I'm not super concerned about it, but I'm gonna be stabbing into the ground here and sticking in pieces of wood. For tools, I'm gonna use chopsticks just to get in there and make holes so that I'm not stabbing the wood itself in there. And I'm gonna be using some trimming tools to kind of trim up pieces as I stick them in or to cut pieces off that I think are too big. So I'm gonna fast forward through most of this so you can see it, but don't have to listen to me drone on. So let's dive right in.
Thank you.
bit closer, show you what we got a little bit closer up, and then we'll look at some of the cuttings that we did just in the same way last year. Take a look and see how those are doing now. Are from last year, so these ones are doing pretty good. I'm going to dig them up and replant them probably in larger pots or the ground a little bit later in the season. You can see my custom pot has seen better days, but otherwise doing pretty good. Obviously they need to get a little bit of water, and you can protect them from the elements, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to stick them out here and hope they get rained on. You'll notice pretty quickly that I gave up on the chopsticks. You're not supposed to just jam these things into the ground because it's not good for the cuttings. But I didn't really have much of a choice. The chopstick thing wasn't working. This is too dense a substrate on both counts for that to work well. So we'll see what happens. I'll post an update in the spring when they start to grow. Thanks for watching.